Hey guys, your boy Coopers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool career mode, where last time left off, he beat both Manchester City and Manchester United on my birthday. And this episode, I'm playing Aston Villa and Stoke. There is a Champions League game sandwiched in between as well. Like in the last episode, but also like in the last episode, it will be simmed because I've already qualified it for the next round, and it doesn't matter. What does matter is this game against Villa, and the game against Stoke. But first, Villa. Damn it.
We're here to describe the action for you. Nice to have you with us. Martin Tyler here and Alan Smith. The game today, Liverpool against Aston Villa. This is the Liverpool side. Rafael Varane cool. With Aymeric Laporte as the centre-backs. Marco Reus starts looking to continue his great form in midfield. In attack,
I should probably get used to playing Villa. Because I don't know if they'll be in the Premier League come next FIFA. But the way their performances have been pretty bad, at least lately in the league, with despite their new manager not having the same effect that people are saying Jurgen Klopp has had at Liverpool. They're right, but I shouldn't hold that again. Wow! That was a fucking cross! Marco Reus after. I noted in the last episode that his goals this season have all been from the penalty spot, and he's like, okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to correct you on this little error. Corey, because here's a nice little goal that was totally meant to be a cross, but Roy says, I'll see you who cross and raise you who goal, because why not? It's completely over the head of Coutinho and Sturridge and Guzan, and Bale, even with all his speed, isn't going to get to that to make it look like a cross. Oh wow, Marco Reus scores a goal that was not a penalty. Hey, good for you, Marco. Oh, I retract my statement from the last episode that all your goals were penalties, even though they were until that point. It's one way to start off this match. Anyway, what was I talking about? Oh yeah, I was talking about Villa's form being poor in real life. No, it's almost weird to see because Villa have been in the Premier League for years. As Coutinho makes it 2-0, takes top spot back from Daniel Sturridge after losing it in the last. Well, they didn't lose it in the last episode. They tied in the last episode. Coutinho's like, nope, I'm just gonna go back in front there, Daniel, who was. Nowhere to be seen. Oh, there he was. Restarting at 2-0. He was chitting off to the side. Anyway, if the players can. Well, I'm not gonna try and stop scoring him. Bale, could you stay on the pitch there, friend? Royce. Barrett. Oh, Marco! He is definitely proving me wrong. And the cross goal, whether it was intentional or not, That one was very intentional. Coutinho with the eye to spot Royce's run. And I don't know a keeper that would have saved that. And Neuer would have had trouble with that. And just boom! He scored from the one side of the pitch and he scored from the other. And all of a sudden, Marker has scored two goals that were not penalties. It's like he's intentionally trying to shut me up. And I'm not intentionally scoring with him. He's just turning up. Good. It's good to see him scoring. Now he might turn and provide our Sturridge scores. It's gotten away. Hey, Henderson. Comes well. About where Royce was. Headed the way. Hey. It's dead. Come on, Varane. Keep it in. Good. Good. Rodriguez. Oh, what a pass. It was meant for Sturridge, but Bale picked it up. If it might still come to Sturridge, it's 4-0. Oh. Well, showing our quality is fantastic. I must have said something massive to this group at before the match. Something I could say. Get out there and score a shit ton of goals. I don't even know if that covers it. Daniel Klein. Sturridge isn't going to get there. Or even with his pace. I think Guzan will be very happy when halftime comes. He won't have to. He can have a bit of a rest period. This could be beating the Crystal Palace scoreline. And to be honest, Coutinho scores again. It's 5. It's 5 just before halftime. I'm starting to really consider this might end up more than Palace, which was 9. Coutinho scores again with his second of the game. He has 2. Sturridge has 1 and Royce has 2. And that's the best thing that could have happened to Villa so far in this first half. The halftime whistle. Oh my lord. Chelsea are winning. City are drawing. Arsenal are drawing. Yes, AU is exactly what you guys need. Unless he's turned into a defender recently. I don't know how much that's going to help. Although, I don't think bringing on extra defenders is he's not exactly going to. I guess he's going for consolation goals. Because I think it's pretty safe to say this match is over. I noted this in the last episode as well, that I scored more at this point than I did almost all the last season. In all the last season, I scored just under 200 goals in all competitions. Before this match, I had 90 goals in all competitions. Now I have 95. leave. And we're not even in January yet. So we haven't even touched the FA Cup. Not to mention the latter stages of the Champions League and just the progression in the Carling Cup as well. And of course, the remaining games in the league. This could be a record-breaking season of some description. And the Sen, oh, he wants his name on the sheet. And not the team sheet, he wants his name on the score sheet.
Goal news now from Norwich, Alamakanali.
It's the second goal for Norwich City. It's been scored by Cameron Jerome. He picked the ball up just inside.
Rodriguez passes too light, or my player moved too soon. Your way, I didn't get the pass, didn't come off. That one did though. Correa. That whips it in. Sturridge. Oh, he was looking for his second. Marco, who is one of two players on the pitch, looking for a hat trick. Chelsea scoring a second goal. So I won't be gaining any points on Chelsea, unfortunately. But hopefully Arsenal and City will drop the 2 points and I'll gain points on them. Arsenal are actually my closest rivals. Correa! Ooh! Come on, Marco, you can get there. Wait, yeah, he did! Where's... Oh, he ran out of play. He tried to avoid the tackle. Oh, well, this second half has flown by. And I bet much to the relief of Villa and especially Brad Guzan, I have not put another goal past them yet. But here comes Sturridge. He's deadly. Oh. Oh, Rodriguez wins it from Ghana. I probably said that wrong. Rodriguez. Oh, he was just... The defender did enough to prevent Rodriguez getting his second goal of the season.
Well, we've been locked in this position for a while.
And Rodriguez goes all Zidane on us. He headbutts some... Ren clears that pretty easy. Pukuna's getting it back. His Ghana again. And there's the full time whistle. Oh, there wasn't. Oh, what more goals? All five came in the first half. And City and Arsenal did drop 2 points each. That's brilliant. And oh, the league. It's not even looking like a league at the moment. Now getting a little closer to a 76, which is good. Seems to be down to the last game for who will get that second place. It's actually still open, look at that. All three teams can still get it, yes? Yes, technically they could. It's going to take a bit of a miracle for CSKA Moscow on one hand, though, They're going to have to beat Inter Milan by 3 goals and hope I beat Celtic. And unfortunately for them, I'm simming the match, so anything is possible. Oh yeah. Sewell is not available for this match, unfortunately. What do I do? Play Emery Can at centre back. I'm always complaining that he is played at centre back, but you know, right now I need him. Don't really have any other options except my main centre backs, and I'm just not. That's not something I'm inclined to do. And of course I got to put Tielemans back in. Play Donza as well, why not? Try to spread the love in the first team around. Well, the second team actually. Laurie, if you could avoid getting a yellow card, that'd be fantastic. So you can actually play in the next round. In the first leg, anyway. And if you could all avoid injury, that'd be fantastic as well. So all I want is no who injuries. Boom! Laurie scores again! That's 2 games in a row! He scored the only goal against... in the 3-1 loss to Inter Milan in the last episode, and he scored the goal. He scored the third goal in the 3-0 thrashing of Celtic. Celtic are out. I don't know. It's not telling me how the other match went. Ings and Camano. Maybe that might help Camano get up to a 67 a bit faster. Cheeky. Confirmation that Arsenal did drop points. Oh, it's getting mad down there. It is getting mad. But, just quickly check who got. Who. What was the result? Oh, wow, CSKA Moscow, they won, but not by enough goals. Inter Milan are into the knockout stages is on goal difference, and CSKA Moscow have actually done enough to earn themselves the Europa League spot because I beat Celtic by 3 goals. Well, they would have been tied otherwise. Although if I'd drawn 0-0 with Celtic, I think Moscow would have... Celtic would have actually gone through because Milan lost. Actually, no, Milan still would have gone through. Celtic. They would have needed Milan to lose by 2 goals. So there you go. Milan summer. Oh, they scraped through by the skin of their teeth. What was I doing? Oh yeah, Tielemans asked me for more money. I can do that. Tielemans. There he is. Whoa! 130! Tielemans, you're lucky here. You think you're a very good player. Or otherwise, you wouldn't be getting this. I can't convince him to sign a 2-year extension. It's just the one. Important first team player. He should accept that. He should. I mean, I'm going to be pretty pissed off if he doesn't. He should. He will. I mean, for $130,000. And Panikin, are you out of your ever-loving mind? And I can't play you in this match. Look at that, Royce is on the top goal scorer list now. There's only 1 point between first and second and third. Arsenal wish there was only a point between me and them. Stoke playing red and white, so I'm going to have to wear my third kit at the Britannia. It's overcast, so we're going to do it in a wet night in Stoke. Hook. That should make you internet fans happy. He'd go nuts with that. don't bog a diving keeper there. Nah, diving's overrated.
Hello everybody, Martin Tyler is my name. Alan Smith is
well,
your
not,
name.
It's not actually raining, but you can see the surface is wet, so it was raining. Is it raining? No, it's not raining. But it was. How do I... No, because the surface is clearly wet. Sturridge sends Coutinho through. Oh, early goal. Boom, Philippe Coutinho. He doesn't need a second invitation. Nice assist from Daniel Sturridge. And Philippe puts away goal number 14. Seriously, where was this goal scoring prowess last season? He was nowhere in it as prolific. I'm not complaining, I'm just curious. That hearing training I put him through during the summer must have been a real big help. I knew that was the right thing to do. Come on, Correa. Foul? No? Really? Okay. Continue smoking wherever you're smoking over there, ref. I'll continue dominating. Oh my god. Wow, of course. I was just about to say if he gave a free kick. Like, what an asshole. Yes, Correa. Tried to play the through ball, but didn't work out. Coutinho. Henderson. Oh, the... Nice turn from Coutinho. Ooh, Butlin was worried. You could tell he was worried. He didn't. Butlin is a good keeper. Butlin has faced Coutinho in real life, and that didn't end particularly well. Well, as he was all the game of the first game of the season, we'll know what I mean by that. Oh, that's in! Yes, Correa scores his first goal in ages. It's like his first goal in about 5 in the league. He mini goal, whole drought, finally ended. And a bit of assistance from the key, but it's in nonetheless. I don't think it's going to be credited as a known goal to Jack Butland. I think it's Correa's goal. Let's just see. I could be given as an own goal, to be honest. Nope, it's been given as Caress. So now he's level with Marco. Although, with how Marco was playing in the last... In the game against Vill, I wouldn't be surprised if he popped up to show us what he is made of. He scored 10 all last season. And he's one away from doing the same in about half the time season. And he's won a free kick. Barkley's staying down. Well, no, I don't think he's going to be booked. Is he? No, he wasn't. I think the referee was just writing down Barkley's name in his warning book or something. It looked like he wrote something, but maybe he's like, right, Barkley, warning. Book next time. Like a mental notebook. Henderson probably shouldn't have gone for the shot there. I did. There you go. Royce! Ooh! Just as I was saying it a bit earlier, that Royce might pop up to go back in front of Correa. Yeah, he almost did, if not for a fantastic save by Jack Butland. Correa. Laporte! Royce! Anderson's bicycle kicking nothing. Royce won't get on the end of this corner because he's taking it. Correa! How might though? Ah, oh, Butland. Just got there first. Uh oh. Well done, Laporte. Back incredibly quick to make sure. Oh, Juf didn't get away at my goal. It's the connection. Him and Varane are on the same page. They're twins at the moment. And when together, they're damn near unbreakable. In terms of defensive. And with Klein and Ricardo. Oh, they formed a solid wall. That is my defense. Chelsea are not looking like they're going to drop more points. And yet, at Leicester are 2-0 down to them. After send Chelsea a little message. Or not, because they cleared it off the line. Lucky sods. Yeah, I was just about to say that was probably a foul there by Correa there on, I think it was Arnautovic. Sturridge. Whip it in. Nope, straight up Butland. Brilliant. As it Sturridge runs straight into the defender, or despite coming away with the ball, Henderson. Jordan Henderson! Gets his shot deflected, but it's enough to warrant a corner. Come on, Gareth, a nice... He's crossing. Wait, that shithead got away. Oh, and his replacement almost banged it. Yeah, that was actually... He probably going in. Because the keeper was in no position to stop it. Marco Royce. Another corner. Hit Bojan. Going out. Big Carling Cup fixture in the next episode. The fixture we avoided in real life. It's actually Stoke we got in real life, ironically. And City got Everton. The Merseyside final, still a possibility. In the Capital One Cup this year. Although, I think the smart money would be on City to win against Everton. I'm not going to count out Stoke, because that's the best way to... Overconfidence leads to... almost always leads to bad karma. And that will almost always leads to bad results. Oh shit! Lost the ball to Juve. Or not? Shit was good. He closed him down quick. I think it was Varane who was in his way. Butlin coming all the way off his line to clear that. Coutinho, Correa's away, there's only one defender back here, where's the rest of the defence, I don't care, Sturridge, how did you miss, oh, they did the hard part by bailing, and Sturridge, it didn't get the best touch on it, but still, that should be in the back of the net, Daniel. No excuses. Why that wasn't in the back of the net. Very disappointing. Henderson. What a ball to Coutinho. Oh, we might make up for it. Hey, Philippe. Coutinho. Oh. Oh. Johnson. Some people would say he fouled him there. This referee does not believe. If so, thinks Johnson got the ball cleanly, which he didn't. Rotten, dirty bastard. Here's Bale. Gonna beat Arnautovic in a game of pace any day of the week. The Butlin is better than Sturridge in the air, apparently. Coutinho. There's Royce. Correa. Come back to Bale. Gareth Bale blocked. It's going to be in a corner. What could easily be the last chance of the game? Varane. It was almost like what happened with Moreno and Origi against Southampton, but in any event, it is 3-0. Daniel Sturridge gets the ball in eventually. Yeah, after all that mass confusion. The shot by Nathaniel Klein, parried away by Butland into the path of Daniel Sturridge. It was probably going to be an own goal, to be honest. If I hadn't got there, the defender would have, and he would have put it into the back of the net. So, I think it's 3-0 any way you look at it. That defender just has to count himself lucky that Sturridge got there first, and he's not credited with an own goal. Oh. Instead, he just kicked Sturridge. Nah. I mean, yes, he conceded 3 goals. Butlin made some fantastic saves that kept this match somewhat competition-ish. Wow, Chelsea 4-0 over Leicester. And Leicester are fucking near the top of the table in real life. Why can't they show that form in freaking in the game? In any event, and that is the end of another episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you join the next episode. I have the cup game against Manchester City, and then I'm playing against Newcastle. Which we've already done in real life by the time you watch this. Although this one will be at the games one is at Anfield, whereas the one on Sunday was, because this is being recorded beforehand, but it's being posted on Thursday. You get the picture. We played Newcastle. It's confusing. Similarities. You are amazed. Heast. See you all next time. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed it. And until next time, I was you all very, very.